Hi and welcome to Straight Up Tech, your very own Unity game development learning channel. Now in the previous video we learned how we can make our own sprites in third party app known as Piscale. Now what we did was we made the sprite, checked the animation and then exported the animation as images. Then what I did was I imported that asset folder into my Unity game environment. As you can see, I have those images here and right now they are true to their name and they are just images. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change these images and make them work as animation in our Unity game view. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select two images and drag and drop them to the Unity hierarchy. Thus it will open the asset folder. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new asset folder and name it as animations and open it. Then I'm going to name animation as bottle animation 1 and then save it. Then I delete this game object because I don't need it right now. Now in this bottle animation you will see that automatically this control is created. What will happen is on the entry the animation will begin playing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the animation and right now I don't want my bottle to change its form, so I'll just delete this keyframe and I will rename this animation as idle and drag and drop this to and I delete this. So now only whenever our animation begin it will be in its idle form, that is the bottle is full. So I'll go back to my game view and my scene view and I'll drag and drop one of my sprite. Now it is not visible in our game view because the sprite is very small, so I'm going to scale it so we can see it. Go something like 20 20. Now we can see our bottle and as soon as we press play it is not going to do anything because we have only created the idle animation. Now what we are gonna do is we'll create the bottle empty animation and play it by using a button. So I'll select all this and drag and drop them to here. It will create another new animation. I'll name this animation as bottle animation and save it. What I'm going to do is I will open the controller. I'll delete the new controller that is being created because I don't need it. And in the older controller which was created, I'm going to drag and drop my new animation inside the animator window. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a transition from idle to bottle animation and here I am going to name this transition in trigger. Whenever we will be applying the trigger it will become true once and after the animation is played it will automatically become false again. So what we are going to do is we are going to name it play, then we will select this transition arrow and select the condition as play. We'll save it. Now back to our scene view. Here what we are going to do is, so I'm going to delete this. In our game object we are going to add a component named animator and then I'm going to drag and drop my animator controller to this animator. Now the controller is set. After this I'm going to create a UI canvas In the canvas, what I'm going to do is I'll name it as animation canvas. Then I'm going to create a new UI button and name it as play animation, and change my button text to play and this to play text. Now I don't want my button to be floating over the object. I'm going to select my button, then drag transform, alt and select this. So now my button is pinned to the bottom of the screen. Then I select my sprite and move it to the center of it. Now we have a button and sprite in place. When we press play, nothing will happen because we have not yet told the button what to do when we press play. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a script. And to play the animation, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my sprite and then add component, name my script as play animation, new script, create an add. Then I'll open my script. Now we will remove all this code which we don't need for now. Now first of all, as we need to play our animation, we need a reference to our animator component. To do that, I'm going to create a reference named anim. So animator and anim. Then I'm going to call an awake function. Awake is called only once when you run the program for the first time. This is mainly used to hold the data from the references you have created, thus making your processes more smooth and fast. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do anim equals to get component from animator. Now after we have got the reference, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a function, name it as void play animation 2D and braces. Now in the function we only have to write one line of code which will automatically trigger our animation, and that will be anim dot set trigger, and we will write the trigger that we have created in animator play. So what this function will do, whenever it is accessed, it will set the trigger and play the animation. We will save it, go back to Unity, and then we will create our reference in our button by setting the button, go to this onClick component, add. Now since we have the script in our sprite, so we will drag and drop the sprite to this, and in our function we will have the play animation script, and in this, okay, we are not seeing the function because we have to put the function to public. So I have to write public void play animation, then only it can be accessed. After this we'll go back, select the button, and now when we see the play animation, now we have a play animation 2D function. We will click it and save the script. Now as soon as we press play, there are no changes because currently the state is in idle state. As soon as I press play, see, the animation starts. It is triggering again and again. This is how you can create your own pixel animation in the third party app Pixels, then import that into your game and use it as your own animation. So this was all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video from us again. Thank you.